Okay, so today we are going to talk about how to uninstall old stories. And in uninstalling old stories, we have to take a deep dive into our minds, into our psyche. And some of these stories can be anything from I'm not smart enough to I'm not good at business, or I'm not business savvy, or I'm always, living paycheck to paycheck, or I'm always, I can never get ahead in life. I'm bad at doing things, bad things always happen to me. I would never succeed in whatever, my own business as a nurse or as a doctor or as a lawyer. Relationships don't work out for me. You know, all these negative talks that we have. But sometimes these negative talks are so much in autopilot that we don't realize we're saying this to ourselves. So in order to find out, deep dive into our psyche, we need to find out how can we find these stories in our lives. And the way to find these stories in our lives is to see what is it that we don't like that is currently happening in our lives. So what outcomes do we keep on unintentionally bringing into our lives? For example, crappy relationships, always broke, never having enough money, just barely enough to eat and pay rent, if that. Having negative and toxic thoughts that sometimes drive you crazy. You can also look through the substances that you take. Find out or ask yourself, as you're taking these substances, why am I taking this? Most of us will say, well, I want to feel good. So why is it that you want to feel good? Why is it that the state that you want to be in, you're not having it right now? And start writing that down. Why is it that I don't feel that good? It's because my job, it's because my boss, it's because of my relationship, it's because of the place that I'm living, it's because, my health is not that great. So just start writing those things down. Why am I taking these substances? Another way to find out your old stories, or the stories you want to uninstall, is by, what is it that you tend to punish yourself for? What is it that you say, oh, you idiot, oh, you stupid, oh, you never do anything right? Almost like taking over your caregiver's roles, your caregivers that weren't supportive, that they weren't loving. When you say things, listen to yourself as you speak to yourself. Find out where that is coming from. Also, find out what scares you. It might even be an illusion. For example, if you want to become a lawyer or a doctor, what scares you is the fact that you might pay for a course and not pass the course. But that's just an illusion, because you don't know the future. Perhaps in the past, you could have failed, in class. I can tell you that I was horrible at school, but I knew one day I decided that I wasn't going to let fear take over me. And if I fail, then I fail. And it's scary. It's scary to know that something that has happened in the past will happen again in the future. But you have to realize that you can't tell the future. You just have to experience life in the present the way it is. And you will find out that the more you believe in yourself, the more you believe in yourself. And it will be just a cycle that you're constantly strengthening the belief in yourself. So let's see. Okay, so what you feel you deserve. Okay, so what is it that you feel you deserve or don't deserve? Write that down. What do you think you deserve or would love to have? And then at the same time, ask yourself, why don't I deserve it? Why don't I deserve a secure income? Why don't I deserve a loving relationship? Why don't I deserve good health? So once you have that all down and you've actually had a moment to put yourself on paper, start reading that out. And now it's time to uninstall those things. The thing is that it's hard to uninstall something unless you put another thing in. For example, if your computer is working well, your computer will stop working well until something else is installed into it. For example, a virus, a malware. So your computer cannot stop working well until something else has been installed into it. So you're going to do it the opposite. That something else is the virus. Now you have to install something better in it. You can't eliminate it completely. Yeah, you can. You can go to a default setting in your mind, but that will be a little more trickier to do than actually installing new programming. Now you write the opposite of that. What is it? So I never can get loving relationships, supportive relationships. Now you write down the opposite. I always have loving, harmonious, fulfilling relationships. Just write that down. Whether you believe it or not, just write that down. So keep on going. I'm always paycheck to paycheck. I'm always living paycheck to paycheck. Instead of that, saying, I always have left over from my paychecks to have fun, to invest, and to save. And so just keep on going along the things that you have noticed in your life that are not working well. And just write the opposite of it. Don't expect anything else of it. This is going to take a long time, just like patching the holes, the leaks, like I did in prior videos. It's going to take a long time, and you have to be patient with yourself. You can't expect it to happen one day after the other, or in a year. You have to be patient because all of these negative stories that you have took time to be installed into your mind. So you need to take some time to uninstall them. There's different ways to do it quickly, but most people would rather not do that. And maybe I can talk about that in some other time if you guys let me know that that's something that you would like me to discuss. So once you have stated the opposite of that, then you start by having affirmations that you write every day and read them out loud so that you can hear them in your ears. Because for years you've been saying, oh, I'm a piece of shit, oh, I can't do any better. And you've been saying that in your ear. It's almost like you're doing an affirmation in your ear, and so you can hear it. So now you got to do the opposite, but with something that is loving, that is supportive, that is going to take you to the place where you want to go. So you start writing these affirmations. Try to do them every single day. If you can do them more times than, a few times in a day, that's fine. If you stop doing them and you're like, oh, I got to get back on them, just get back on them. It doesn't matter. Just be patient, loving, and supportive with yourself. And know that if you didn't do it yesterday or the day before or the week before, you can always get back on and start it again. So start exposing yourself to the things and the people that you want to embody in your life. And it doesn't have to be, if you say, well, I don't know anybody that has a loving relationship, or I don't know anybody that's rich, or I don't know anybody that doesn't live from paycheck to paycheck. It doesn't matter. Yes, you can find people that you would like to be like. You can watch videos of people that you would like to be like, embody that essence of those people. You can read books, you can go to communities that embody that and are working towards that type of lifestyle, that type of being. One community that I like a lot is Toastmasters, because it's very difficult to speak in public. If you're able to, with a supportive community, to do something that's difficult, then you are more inclined to do more things that are more difficult, because now you have something to say, well, if I could do that, then I can do this too. Another one is when you get a thought about yourself that is negative, that's gonna take you back, just in your mind say, cancel that. I have loving relationships, instead of, oh, nobody ever loves me, or nobody, or I never have money, or I'm always in trouble. Say, I walk through life with peace, calm, and tranquility. I never have money. I always have enough to take care of my needs and my wants. Just cancel it. You know, you don't have to stay. I know it's a habit to say mean and cruel things to yourself, but you don't have to take it. You can just cancel it. Just like if a friend told another friend something mean and you were like, don't say that, don't do that. You can do that for yourself. You can stick up for yourself. So like I said, I'm going through the whole diagram of abundance, and that's part of abundance. It's that programming that, yes, I can live in a way that is peaceful, tranquil, fruitful for me. And that's part of the series, Abundance Series, is to uninstall your stories, the old stories that you don't want, and install the new ones, or the ones that you do want. So if you can like and subscribe, and if you want to leave a comment, leave a comment, and I will see you in the next video.